Captain Castro, you've been you're with a cavalry unit up in Alaska. You've served also throughout the rest of the world. Walk me through, given all the happy talk we heard from the administration, you know, now we have their put out an alert this morning that all U.S. citizens must leave Russia. Okay? That's an escalation. In the intelligence world, would that be considered an escalation?
Absolutely. And also, you have some things that are showing you what the true picture on the ground is. Recently, the Ukrainian government put out a warning for no aid workers to enter Bakhmut, despite the Ukrainian government's claims that they're holding ground. And of course, that's their symbolic stronghold against the Russian invasion. Now, as we mentioned during the break, the Russians, of course, are bombarding that place. And the reason given is aid workers shouldn't enter because of street fighting. So they're not even able to secure basic areas of Bakhmut in which they were thought to be held and peaceful at this point. I think that's a sign that Bakhmut is getting ready to fall, and a lot of the propaganda you see in the media drumming up support for every nation to oppose Russia is exactly that. It's more propaganda, just like we discussed with the Chinese spy balloon before the break.
You saw where we put forward 31, we gave them 31 M1 A1 Abrams tanks, the battle tanks, to quote-unquote lead a springtime offensive to then pivot and liberate Crimea. That was the talk 2 weeks ago. Given your experience, how tough do you think it is for the civilians in Bakhmut in those strategic hamlets? Because right now, two of the small villages outside Bakhmut are just under complete barrage by the Russian artillery. You know how good the Russians are on artillery, and they will drop some gross tonnage on you and not think twice about it. How tough do you think it is for the civilians in that general area right now, Captain Keschel?
I think it's extremely difficult because the infrastructure in the area is being completely obliterated. You can find it really in some of the back channels of the internet. You can find some channels in Telegram that have a lot of drone footage of the area. It's completely in ruins. And it's not so much that they're going to have access to more firepower with tanks or any sort of weaponry we send. But as every single military operation that has failed in human history, going back beyond earlier, well earlier than Napoleon, if you cannot sustain your force, if you cannot have the beans and bullets, if you cannot give them proper equipment and you can't support the armor with infantry, then you're going to fail in the operation. So really, I consider that to be really a bunch of gold plating that's not going to amount to much, us lending them so much firepower because they can't support that.
In a combined arms operation, which is what the tanks give you, because it's not just a weapons platform, it's a whole different type of warfare. Is it feasible, sir, given the complexity of the M1 A1 Abrams tank, that you can't have logisticians, American logisticians, maintenance, training, all of that around those tanks when they show up, whether they're in defense of these villages and towns in eastern Ukraine or whether they really try to do a combined arms operation to liberate Crimea? Is there any way, do you think, In the short term, and by short term I would say between now and the end of the year, that could be sustained by anything but American military personnel?
That's what it would take to sustain the operation. Now, of course, the stakes of bringing Americans into that conflict, look at every war in Europe for the last 150 years. When one nation gets involved, it triggers all the alliances and it brings the whole world into what we've been discussing on the show is World War III scenario. So I don't believe that that is what is going to happen. I think there's a lot of posturing about the issue. But no, it would not be possible to push back and regain that lost ground, I think, without direct military involvement, which is why I am hopeful that that is not going to happen on our end.